Students, now revision of lesson number 5, the 12 months. In a far away country, there lived a mother who had two daughters. One was her own child, the other was her stepdaughter. She was very fond of her own daughter, but she hated her stepdaughter. The only reason was that Marouckla, the stepdaughter, was prettier than her own daughter, Helena. Marouckla had to do all the housework, tidying up the cottage, cooking, washing, spinning, weaving and sewing. She liked work and she did it all without complaint. One day, the mother and Helena decided to throw her out in the freezing cold to get rid of her. First day, they asked to bring violets. Next day, strawberries. And on the third day, red apples. Every time, the months like great January, March, June, September helped her. At last, mother and Helena went in the forest to bring apples. They not spoke politely with months. Great January frowned. Sky grew dark. Then Helena and her mother could not find their way to home and lost it in the snow. Marouckla waited and went to search them, but she found neither her mother and sister nor the 12 months. So good Marouckla inherited the cottage and the land around it. She married a kind husband and they both lived happily. In this way, this lesson finished. I think you understood this lesson. Then go to lesson number 6, announcements. Announcements can be written orally. For example, here given some notice. First notice is given about cleanliness. Then second notice is given about change in the school hours. In third notice, given information about the football match. Next one, storytelling competition. Then warning, and last one is lost and found. In this way, different notice we can see, and with that notice you can get some information clearly. Then lesson number 7, Major Dhyanchand. Saturday, 15th August 1936, it was the day of the hockey finals during the Olympic events held in Berlin, Germany. Germany had defeated several teams to enter the finals against the Indian team. They were the hosts of the Olympic and they were sure of their victory. Perhaps that was the reason why their ruler Hitler had himself come to watch the match. All the day before, it had rained heavily. The entire field had become waterlogged, but 15th August being the last day of the games, it was not possible to postpone the match any further. The Indian team was a little under pressure as they had lost to Germany in the practice match and they were not very comfortable with the wet ground. About 40,000 people had gathered in the hockey stadium to cheer Germany against India. While playing, Dhyanchand's spiked shoes were making it difficult for him to run fast on the wet ground. So, he removed his socks and shoes and began to run barefoot. The Indian team scored 3 gold medals. The German strategy had proved fruitless, then the German goalkeeper pounced on Dhyanchand and hurt him. Then also he began to play again. At last he scored the last goal of the match just as the game drew to a close. The Indian team had won third time in a row. Indians were the third time winner of the Olympic gold medal. Hockey is our national sport. National Sports Day is celebrated on August 29, which is Major Dhyanchand's birthday. I think this lesson also you understood very well. Thank you.